Page 5. This difficulty gives rise to the second half of the disjunction above. Some writers do not know what they are writing about. They recognize the impossibility of defining religion and rely on its familiarity to satisfy the reader. L. W. Grinstead, in The Psychology of Religion, remarks in his foreword that the subject is nebulous and ill-defined. No one part of it has any clear logical or scientific priority. Quote, there is always lurking about whether religion is a proper study for psychology at all. And a few pages later, he admits that, quote, the definition of religion is impossible. Thus, the only means of saying what we mean by religion must be empirical, descriptive, and accumulative. We must, in fact, return to what ordinary folk understand by religious behavior, unquote, page 15. This initial admission of failure, however, does not prevent the gentleman from writing his book, a humorous paradox that he himself seems to enjoy. Now, there are powerful reasons for accepting the position that religion cannot be defined. In fact, such is the main conclusion of this chapter. It will be shown definitely that we cannot, with confidence, to repeat a phrase from King, assume that religion has a distinguishable meaning. This conclusion sometimes leads to the clear-sighted muddle-headedness of Grinstead. There is, however, another alternative to be mentioned later. But for the moment, and particularly at the opening of the discussion, one should not merely assume the impossibility of defining religion. It is better to examine the two chief methods used in attempting to frame a definition, and if in so doing we are fairly convinced that the problem is insoluble, we shall have learned the precise reasons for the failure.